Ladies and gentlemen, welcome once again with a week off to the Flummery. Back again.
Check it, direct it.
To the place where your hopes and dreams are crushed like a boulder flowing down the mountain, hitting a car and pushing you off the edge and crushing you into the river valley below. We are back once again, risen from the ashes with a week off. Back here today, I have my good friend Frosty. How are you, Frosty?
I'm good.
Yeah.
Due to a feces thrown all over the walls.
Yep.
That's, it stunk so bad.
That's what I have to say so far.
We are, for a third week, missing our cohort, Scuba Steve.
Should we tell him about, like, how he got hit by a bus, or?
He was the one that got hit by the boulder in the car that crushed the side of his car and flew.
And his skull.
Well, it knocked his car with the boulder into the river valley below.
Yeah.
And as soon as the car hit, the boulder hit on top of it. So he was crushed.
I was outraged.
Me too.
Yeah, he's going to be all right. He just talked like this now.
Who talked like this
now? He talked like this now because he almost drowned with the boulder hit the car.
Oh, he's got the gooning going on.
That apparently,
you know,
is
what the gooning is?
No.
The gooning is like an MMA move where you, like, you know, you can't get fully underneath their chin and you're trying to, like, choke them out.
Do you choke them out with their own face?
So, like, they're pushing up on your arm and you're trying to choke them out. At that point, they're pushing it up onto their face. So the guy that's doing the headlock goons their face, you know, like, distorts it a little bit. You know, like, you're not getting the choke. You're just gooning their head.
That fucking
kind of like sloth.
So basically, you're trying to dislocate their jaw.
Well, they're still putting pressure, trying to get underneath your jaw to choke you out. But
they enjoy it.
They can't get underneath. So there's a word they call it, gooning your face.
And so, how long has that been a term?
I would never do anything like that.
No, Michael.
Michael's being, like, really polite.
I heard that through Joe Rogan. They were talking about it. It's actually pretty funny. It's been a term in MMA for, I don't know, quite a while now.
Okay, so I saw a guy we talked about. Well, I don't know if I talked to you about him, but somebody had suggested him. Let me look his name up real quick. He's the Machine, and he, like, is the inspiration for Van Wilder. It's Bert Kreischer.
Yeah.
And did you know about him?
No.
Because somebody was telling me about
the name.
Him that we know.
For the name.
Yeah. Somebody was telling me about him that we know. Somebody we know was telling me about him. I'm going to say it three different ways.
Do it.
Someone that we know was telling us about him. And I watched his,
so
I watched
an, his he's an
special
author.
On YouTube. He's a comedian. And then he did a show called Hurt Bert. And then Bert the Conqueror, where he did it. Hurt Bert was, he did a bunch of, like, dangerous jobs that other people do.
Mm-hmm.
And then Bert the Conqueror, he did a bunch of just, like, you know, roller coasters, skydiving, that kind of shit. So it was, I don't think his shows, honestly, I doubt I'll be, like, watching a lot of his shows, but I saw his special and it was very good.
Slash, like, a life adventure kind of guy?
Yeah, he went to
kind of like a Dan Bilzerian.
Yeah, I think he's a little more funny than Dan. But
Dan's not a comedian. He's just kind of one of those guys that gambles. And he's a meathead that sleeps with a lot of women and gambles.
Yeah, actually, meatheads don't usually get laid as often as people would think, but he does. He gets laid a lot.
Well, he's...
I'm thinking he's paying for it.
I don't know how he... Yeah, well, he's already died technically once or twice because of a heart attack.
Yep.
He was actually on Joe Rogan not too long ago, too.
He's all right. I get him. I get what he's doing.
What do you think he's doing? I don't really get him. I really never...
He's just living... balls out, like, as much as he can.
Yeah.
And it's gotten him in trouble a few times. I'm afraid
he doesn't give a fuck, does he?
Thriller.
Yeah. I don't know if we can edit that out.
What?
The thumps.
I'm not going to edit the thumps out.
I don't think we're going to do these anymore.
No.
We'd have to do one every 5 seconds just so that it doesn't, like, do
load
that. And if we had to do that.
I would slip my wrist.
Yeah, sorry. You're already dead, Michael.
The one the one below that.
Yes, he does now.
I see the face of God.
Yep, you're there.
That's Steve after he got crushed into the valley below.
Yeah, exactly.
And then he sings this.
I'm back. I play Pokemon Go every day.
still my favorite. One of my favorites.
I never played that game. Have you played that game?
I played it for about 3 days, and that is about as far as it went. Yeah, I got to like level 5. I got to the bottom level where you can start being like managing the gyms and stuff, and I'm like, that's too much work. I have 2 kids. There's already shit I don't do at home that I should do.
Right. Me too. I do the same. I got kids at home, and I got a bunch of shit I don't like, get done.
Yeah, drain babies. You have drain babies.
Drain did, babies?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
When you beat off in the shower and your babies go down the drain.
Oh, that's more on the couch and tissues.
Not buying that couch. No.
Don't worry, I keep it clean.
You have to unzip the cushions when you're done then, or what?
Mm-hmm. I wash the cushions.
I would just suggest not like coming on them.
I just use a baseball glove.
You're using my mitt?
It's a catcher's mitt.
What is it? How does it go? Oh, that's funny. In Casey Affleck comes downstairs.
Yeah. Stop using my baseball glove.
Breathing heavy. Yeah. Like, Jesus Christ. You're in my mom's room jerking off of my baseball glove.
That was a good movie.
It was.
Robin Williams, too, man.
Well, and then that reminds me of... Oh, yeah. It's not your fault. That reminds me of...
It's not your fault.
I know.
It's not your fault.
I know, man. Hey.
Don't fuck with me.
Oh, that's you. Yeah, you better let me. You remember the other side.
Not you, man. Not you. Don't do this to me.
It's not your fault.
It's fine.
I mean it. It's not your fault.
It's fine.
Well, it's not your fault.
Hey, man. Don't do this to me.
It's not your fault.
No, it's fine.
Okay, wait. Do we hug?
We can.
Okay, so what it reminded me of... Now what? I forgot what it reminded me of. Oh, it's when Bill Burr is talking about how he's like, hey, I'm not a fucking... I'm not from Southie. I'm from a better part of Boston. We live in the suburbs. I don't like them apples, if you know what I'm talking about. Because he's comparing... You know, he's talking about being from Boston. Yeah. And he's like, I'm not fucking Goodwill Hunting or Will Hunting. You know, that's pretty funny. Now... Because I mentioned hugs, is that why you lowered the lights?
Yeah, I was going to get a candle in here, too.
Oh, yes. Oh, jeez.
You just turned on the lights.
Please turn the lights back up. I just automatically started beating off when they came down.
Gross.
No, that's good. Well, okay, so I figured, I mean, look at the first one that I put on the list. I mean, when I say the show.
Or three show.
You have to know what I'm talking about, right? We have to talk about the show.
Oh, the show that happened last weekend.
Yeah, no, the weekend before.
Oh, yeah.
25th. March 25th.
I suppose it's 2 weekends ago now, isn't it?
Yes.
It's Monday night.
It was awesome. I'm still hungover.
We do this podcast on Monday nights.
Monday nights. Forget about it.
Monday nights.
You ever heard of a Monday night podcast? Fucking forget about it.
Yeah, so we had a show at the Fineline. The band Eric... opened up for Arson City, which hail out of Omaha, Nebraska.
Mm-hmm. I'll talk about them a little bit later.
And then we had Throw the Fight, which are making a comeback as far as I know.
They are. Kind of a...
Hiatus.
Throw the Fight, what would you compare them to? Kind of a...
I wasn't really familiar with them. I've seen them before a long time ago, and I guess I didn't pay attention to this last time. They're really punky meets like...
Kind of like
a screamo deathcore kind of deal, isn't it?
I'm trying to think of a band that...
They're very rancidy, punky, but...
I wouldn't compare them to rancid,
but heavy.
But yeah, they're like...
they have a punk sense to them,
like
too.
Rise Against, kind of.
Yeah.
Yeah, Rise Against is better, but...
Well, whatever. I guess I don't listen to that.
Well, they're, like, super accomplished. They've got a couple of good CDs, but... Yeah, it's something you got to be in the mood for.
Yeah.
I thought they put on a great live show, but again, it's... I think the two middle bands, and I don't think I gave...
Well, let's mention Cold Kingdom was...
Yeah, absolutely.
The
sorry.
And, yeah. All right, go ahead.
Yeah, Cold Kingdom was the headliner, the headbanging headliners. I got their new EP. I listened to it for about 3 days in a row.
Yeah.
Yep.
Which was produced by Eric Bass.
Yep. Wait.
Bass.
Okay, cool. I'm the one that gets it wrong.
He plays the bass, but his last name
is Bass. I know. Eric Bass. Well, that's cool. Yeah. Oh, no. I'm saying it wrong on a podcast, which is not cool of me to do.
Fucking.
Probably fucking research that
delete,
next time.
Delete. Lost 4 more listeners this week.
Fuck. Should we? Oh, we're here. Should we look?
What?
How many subscribers we have?
107.
Oh, yes.
Oh, on YouTube?
I think it's still 10.
Yeah, probably.
So we need you to subscribe to us on YouTube.
Or prescribe.
We're going to prescribe you a remedy to your ills. What you need to do is subscribe to us on the Flummery podcast on YouTubes.
Yeah, it's not officially a site, like it's not officially youtube.com/.
It's our channel, though.
The Flummery, which it will be eventually, but we need you to help us out and go like, listen, comment, share, all the above. Mainly just subscribe to us. That would be the best way to go.
And then, the best fucking way. That'd be awesome.
And then you can listen to us.
How many subscribers does Misha have? No way. Who subscribes to this?
I don't know. It's, you see, things like that, you don't subscribe to. You just, I mean, that's why it's got 52 million views.
But no, but it only has 620,000 subscriptions.
Yeah, most of them live around the Moscow area.
Oh, we love you, Misha.
Misha,
come in. You sing.
He has a hit in the Republic of Russia.
You sing to President Putin this week. You're the best music in all of Mother Russia.
Let's talk about the show and finish it off.
Yeah, so
we open.
It was a good show. Arson City, I didn't give them enough credit. You know why?
I really didn't. So before the show was done, we're just hanging out down in the green room. It was really cool.
That'd be awesome.
Just warming up, hanging out. And I don't want to, like, with that, like, before you go on, you don't want to sit and hang out with people. You want to just get your head in the zone and hang out. And we're downstairs. And
those couple of lines.
Yeah, a couple of lines of Arson City.
Off their butts.
Yeah, off their butts. But I didn't realize who was in the band or who wasn't. We were hanging out. It was hanging out with all the guys from Arson City, and they're telling jokes and having a good time. And those guys were fucking really cool, man.
They are.
Really nice guys. And I'm not like sitting here to stroke their egos or anything, but
yeah, they'll probably never hear that.
Super, super cool guys. And that's what I'll take from that show, is how cordial and nice those guys were.
So Lance says that your guys were fucking awesome to him in the green room. I'll tell you what, I'll tell you why I didn't give him enough credit. Because of the makeup and like costume type.
Yeah, I mean, they were contact. One of the guitar players, he was wearing like an off-colored contact, and they had like, you know, the grungy stuff.
Right, the guy who did the acoustic guitar on the far side of the stage?
Yeah.
Is that him?
No, the guy that's closer to the green room.
He was really headbanged pretty good. That was pretty awesome watching him play, though.
Yeah.
He fucking rocked it. You know what? They put on a great show, though, and immediately, the first song.
Did they do a cover or something?
They did. It was like Black Keys or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I remember listening to a song. I mean, my thing was, after I got done with the show, we had to pack up, and then I caught like half their set. And when I was doing my rounds out there and like listening, I'm still busy talking to people because everybody's like approaching you at that
point. Oh, yeah. I can see how they really impressed me, I thought. And then I ended up watching a couple more videos on YouTube, because usually before I go to a show, I'll try and watch one or two videos of each of the bands.
Yeah, you want to kind of know what you're getting into. Yeah. I'm the same way. Like, if I play with another band that I'm not familiar with, I always check their stuff out.
Yeah, and so at first I was like, oh, man, you know, these guys. And then they played, and I was like, these guys. And, you know, it's different that... Oh, that's going to start right away, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
It's different that... What am I saying here? Okay, it's not bad to have a niche. But when I thought it was a gimmick, and it turned out to not be a gimmick, it turned out to be their show, you know? And so it was a good show, I thought.
Yeah.
Yeah. That was my
point. Like, the singer came out with, like, this circus Piccadilly that was pretty cool.
I actually really liked the hat, yeah.
And then, well, he ended up getting naked. I remember one of the girls that was, like, one of my friends that I work with, Jessica. She's like, oh, I really like those guys. She's like, but after he took his like shirt off and stuff, like, I could see half of his pubes out of his pants.
I'm back.
He looks like a special needs kid, doesn't
he's,
he?
He's Russian. He's Russian, right, dude.
Back on board.
Yeah, back on board. So, yeah, but back to reality, back to the real reason I went. Eric had a great show. Yeah, Eric's.
I love Eric's.
Eris is the name of the band. And you guys did really good. I liked it. I thought it was your best stage show.
It was really tight up there.
I know. Well, and because as the show goes, something they probably don't realize is you guys all have equipment, right?
Yeah.
So the last two acts have almost a full stage because the first two acts peel their stuff back.
It's called backlining, and you take your amps, and like the last band, the headliners, their amps are in the very back, obviously. Yeah. And then the third, or the,
it was like a tall tower of Cold Kingdom has.
And then plus Cold Kingdom sound. Had they had their lights on stage too, which took a little room, but it was cool. I mean, it worked out.
That was a great light show too. I got some really good video of Danny like with the lights behind her, like you can't see her face, and it looks like she's, you know, fire, like it's she just got beamed down and fire in the sky, you know. I can't.
Blue eyes.
I was like, oh man. I was like, well, she looks really hot today.
I watched her put on her makeup downstairs.
Woo-hoo. Yeah, they killed it too. But you guys, I thought it was your best stage show. And I was going to ask, when you got up there and you're like, holy shit, the Fine Line is almost full at this point. It's already almost full.
Yeah.
And so you've had a couple of good shows with a nice core group of people, but then all of a sudden you get to perform in front of like three other bands, you know, favorite people come to see the show. You know what I mean? Like their folks came to see, and then you get some others who bought tickets cause it's the Fine Line. And then you've got your group of fans. And so I'm wondering like, what was that like to kind of have the biggest crowd so far for your band?
I mean, I've played in, you know,
it was exciting
for this band. I was our biggest one. I've played in crowds like that before, but it was cool.
Oh, I suppose, but
I actually laid at the Fine Line like that before too. And in Milwaukee, but yeah, I mean, it was surreal because it's been several years since I've been on stage like that. You know,
it was good. You were let loose a little. It was kind of cool.
Yeah. I had my nervous parts.
You almost killed the lady with the microphone.
Yeah, I knocked the microphone off of my guitar. She was laughing about it.
Oh, that worked out the best. Like,
she's like, oh,
everybody got a kick out of
it. Knocked his mic stand into me. She wasn't ugly either.
No, she wasn't. Who was that?
I don't know. I've seen her around before. I don't know who she's friends with.
But Randy.
Yeah, she was cute.
It was a really good crowd. I ended up seeing somebody I hadn't seen in a long time, which was awesome. But
old boyfriend from college.
Yeah.
Remember when real we used to spoon on that old
not
ugly couch?
Like boyfriend, but like a threesome partner.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like the devil's threesome all the time.
Like it was you and another dude and then another
Eiffel
chick.
Tower.
And then you guys
like what we do now.
Spent more time on each other than the girl.
No, but you get a lot of time like supporting each other, Eiffel Tower stuff. I don't want you to get jealous though, because it's our thing now.
Yeah.
So
I won't get jealous. That was then. This is now.
But yeah, so the send off for Cold Kingdom was really a blast, and
it was a great show. It was a good turnout. We almost opened up the upstairs because we could have probably had more people up there, but it would have cost us extra money to do it.
Oh, of course. I mean, that's how they're gonna do it, right?
You know,
mm-hmm.
They were gonna charge us another $500 to open up the upstairs.
Well, could you have filled it?
Maybe.
Oh, I got there with my ticket, and Jason was right by the door.
Yeah, did you finger his butthole?
I wish he was wearing leather so I couldn't get in there.
Oh, yeah.
But when they were very good jeans. He had a leather jacket on, kind of hung down. So, but I hand the guy my ticket. He's like, what's your last name? I'm like, Ingebretson. He's like, okay. He's like, did you just buy this? I'm like, what? No. I bought it like 3 weeks ago. I'm like, I got it on Ticketfly. And he's like, oh, cool, thanks. And then he's like, can't find my name. But Jason's standing right there. Jason turns. He looks. He's like, oh, he's cool. The guy doesn't do anything, I guess, because Jason's helping with the door, obviously.
Right.
Because he was running that show, essentially, right?
Jason put that show together.
Yeah, he kind of, so you call it like a producer type thing where he's selling the tickets. And right. So he's just like, yeah, he's good. I'm like, I really did pay.
What happened?
They didn't have me on the list of the ticket holders, but it didn't matter. There was a scanner on the ticket and everything.
Oh.
It just didn't get to that part yet. He was just like, he's good. And they're like, okay, can you see ya?
That's cool.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah. Yeah, the show turned out really good. I was pretty happy about it, you know. Nice burp. Was happy with the turnout. I think Jason and Cold Kingdom were happy with the turnout. I don't think for not opening the upstairs at the Fine Line, I think that the
it was completely full.
It was the whole downstairs was full.
There was three deep at the bar, and there was the area where they sell merch and stuff, basically like a path for a person to walk through, and that was it.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, it was completely full.
Yep.
Yeah, it was pretty exciting.
I love the Fine Line, and I dislike the Fine Line.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Well, okay, so here's the deal. There was something wrong with the sound
With us?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. I heard.
And it didn't totally take away from the show, but like your mic was too low when you were doing the background, you know, when you guys really belt out. Oh, what is the name of that song?
Hear It After.
Yeah, or you do a lot of the background.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah.
Zach and I sing like kind of a harmony.
Yep.
Or a second part to a chorus kind of deal.
And that was too low. They didn't have that. We could see you singing. And I was close enough to kind of hear you guys yelling a little bit too.
Yeah.
But it wasn't coming through.
Yeah, I know there's problems, but you
and it sucks because you want to think that that guy is going to be like one of the best.
Another problem. I had another problem with my monitor. It was blaring Kevin's guitar.
Oh, fuck.
That's all I could hear was his fucking guitar.
Well, luckily, you know, and he sounded awesome, but we could hear the whole band out.
Yeah, it's different in the front. It's different that when you hear the...
Yeah, he's talking about the monitors, I guess. If people don't know, they're...
Personal monitors.
The personal monitors that kind of... They're the ones that are angled up in the front of the stage facing.
They're for us.
Yeah.
It's our mix. We hear what we want to hear. I thought I had that dialed in, and by the time we went and played, it was me and Kevin blaring, and then I told him to turn me down after the first song. And all of a sudden, it was Kevin fucking blaring, and after the second song, I'm like, turn Kevin down. And then it was just Kevin still blaring, and I'm like, well... I'm not going to sit here and ruin the show by telling what the sound guy to fucking do.
Like Toots and the Maytals?
You just play the show. It's never always going to be perfect. Right. You just have to do the best that
you can.
And
it did, like you did. It did sound better out there, but it can be distracting. I can see that.
Oh, it's totally distracting.
But yeah, you guys did a pretty clean show, I thought.
A lot of people
getting tighter. You're getting tight. Yeah, like a toy guy.
We need some more. We need under a belt. It's fine. We'll get there. You know?
I had to talk about it because that was a good night for me. You know what? I didn't even get drunk.
Really?
No, I drove home. I had a few beers.
I stayed at a hotel a block away.
Did you?
Yeah.
What did you guys do?
We packed up. I got done packing and everything done by 1:15, and I took my backpack and put it on my back, and the rest of the band drove off and took the equipment with, and I was like walking down, and used to be Rosen's Bar or whatever.
Yeah, I know right where that is.
I walked down there and had...
What is that now?
I don't remember. I went in there and there's two chick bartenders, and I was like, all right, girls, let's do some fucking shots. And they're like, okay. And I was like buying the bartender shots.
So, well, we maybe shouldn't say, are they allowed to do that?
Why? No, that was fine.
I don't know.
I asked them. You know,
there's only six people are going to listen.
I had a couple beers and like 16 million shots in a half an hour with the bartenders. And it was,
I can't, you didn't ask anybody to go with you?
No, everybody was leaving. Everybody was packing up and
for
leaving.
What? Like, hey, let's party.
It was me like, let's get a quick buzz on and catch my hotel.
Catch my hotel.
Catch my hotel. How about that?
Catch my hotel sick. How about that?
That was great. It was a little stressful. We got a parking ticket because Fineline sucks, and loading and unloading on Fineline fucking sucks too. Yeah. That's what I'm saying about the... Here's the deal with the Fineline. Love them. What?
That's creepy.
Yeah.
Go on.
The loading and the equipment handling with where you put it, there's no place to put shit in that fucking place.
Really?
Yeah. You can't, because we go... There's a hallway that goes to the bathrooms, and then past that, there's another hallway, which brings you outside of the alleyway on the side again. And you can't...
Actually,
you can't put...
I did see that because I was looking for somebody.
They have one small little room to the left past the bathrooms, and all of our bands were trying to put our shit in there, and it was just piled up, and there was no order to it whatsoever.
Fuck.
And you can't put it in the hallway because it's a fire hazard.
Yeah. Yep.
And then the security guy is like, hey, get the stuff out of the hallway. I'm like, we're working on it.
Well, and it's not like they don't know that's a fucking...
What do you
issue?
Think? We're just going to... It's going to go boop and be in the room automatically, and everything's fucking...
Wiggle your nose.
Yeah.
Ding, 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 ding. Skling.
So it was a little stressful with that. And that's my biggest concern with the Fineline is like equipment loading and all that stuff. It's a hard area.
It's no everybody's bar. I'll tell you that.
Everybody's bar,
yeah.
Chippewa Falls.
Yeah, we love those guys.
May 6th.
I should try and find a way to get down there because it sounds like a pretty sweet place.
That's fun.
And I know somebody over there who would probably love to see a rock show
right around the corner too.
Ooh, I should call my friend Eric. Not the band.
You know, okay, so that hotel in Minneapolis, I paid $75 for that night.
That's good.
It's like a brand new hotel.
Oh, was that the hourly rate?
Yeah, Marcos left at 5 a.m.
Goodbye, Marcos.
Thank you. Here's the rose for your evening.
Adios.
He left a glass of water wrapped in a
Damn,
in
you.
A, in paper like this? Kind of like a Robert De Niro in Heat when he did it to that chick when he left her.
I don't know.
Remember that?
What does he say?
Oh, remember he hooked up with that architect chick? He never talks to her, really. He fucking sleeps with her. Bangs her, leaves her. At
he's
like
not very nice to her.
No, he's not.
What a dick. She's not that hot anyway.
She is not.
No, I do remember now. And he's always, you got to be ready to move in 30 minutes or less.
Well, he was struggling whether to fall completely in love and or deal with shit that he needed to deal
with.
He had to deal with Wayne Grow at the end of that movie.
Yeah, he had to kill.
He couldn't let it go. He couldn't let Wayne Grow go.
Because he killed his friends. He narked on him, killed his friends.
And he's like, I got to do one more thing. And he's bringing her along.
So you don't blame him at that point.
He brings her along with it in the fucking Camaro that he's driving. Mm-hmm. And he's like, wait.
That green, gross Camaro.
It's like a teal.
Yeah, it's gross.
And he's like, there's one thing. He's like, sees the exit where he's staying. And he's like, wait, I got to handle one more thing.
That's awesome when he does that, though. He goes in there, he gets the jacket from the wait staff, mm-hmm. and he knows that the fucking cops are watching the place. He still gets in there, and he just blows them away.
Yep.
Totally awesome.
I love it when Wayne Grove's looking through the pinhole, and De Niro's got his back.
Boom!
And he just, like, he's got his back, and he's like a director, like, directing people down the hall, you know?
Yeah.
So he's like, whatever. Yeah, and then he busts the door open and
fucking knocks him right in the head.
What was it, like two in the chest or one in the head or something like that?
Yeah, execution style. Yeah. It was beautiful. That's how you get rid of a bad guy.
Two in the chest, one in the head, or two?
I don't know. I think it's whatever execution style is. Right.
So, yeah.
I'm not an executioner. I don't know.
You just do Eiffel Towers. Is that a fart?
Do you know? I mean, snorting. Thinking about Eiffel Tower.
How was your weekend?
It was good. Lots of kid daddy time, which today turned into kids getting in trouble for being naughty all weekend.
Why? Did you feed them lots of sugar?
No, it's like they get real excited around like 4 or 5 and 6 p.m. They get real ramped up and they fight with each other and then they fight with us. And it's just like, oh my God, you gotta stop. Stop. Quiet. But yeah, don't say another word. Silence. Yeah, it's not fair of us, but it is totally fair. We can shut them up and settle them down. Yeah, but no, yesterday was good. We had a good, we had some good time together. That's all. That's good quality time.
So just so I don't let you guys know, we had to vacate last week's episode of the Flummery because you were vacating. Otherwise, we wouldn't have went through it. Adam and I went through it. Steve couldn't make it again. But I was literally on the couch from Sunday night to Thursday afternoon with butt piss.
Piss ass?
Yeah. And you know what's cool? Like, you don't have much to eat, and then you just eat a whole bunch of Nilla wafers.
That's right. That was you. Why is that your thing?
I don't know. I love Nilla wafers when I'm sick.
You kind of stumble up the stairs. You're all dehydrated. You're like,
oh, super dehydrated. I lost like 10 pounds of water weight, man.
Nilla's.
I went to
you
the
reach up.
I drove
your
to the grocery
takes
store.
Takes them out of the cabinet and throws them to you. Eat these. Like, Nilla's.
Nilla wafers. No, I actually went to the.
They don't crunch. They just go.
Yeah, yeah, I love it.
Dip those in milk. They'll disintegrate, right?
No, I actually went to the. I struggled to go to the store one afternoon on Tuesday, and I felt like crap. And I thought I was gonna pee my butt in the store at
you
one point.
Pee your asshole out. You can't get pink sock.
I had really bad stomach aches. Really bad. I haven't had stomach aches since I was a kid.
What?
Yeah.
You've got iron guts?
I think so.
Okay. Old iron insides.
Weird. Like, I haven't felt that way in a long time.
Hey there, old iron insides.
Mm-hmm.
How's it going? Are you going to win the war? Nope.
That's a war machine. Project War Machine.
Project Metal Guts.
Does that say on your koozie there?
Yeah, it says Project War Machine.
What is that?
Part of something at my business that I work at was way too...
Is it in your business?
Yeah, we had to reach certain goals that were very high, and we did. And one of the engineers, who was awesome, and it sucks because I don't work with him anymore, but he's like one of the awesome ones. He called it Project War Machine. He got everybody like koozies and lunch boxes and got everybody fired up, and we accomplished it. It was good. We accomplished our goals, which I can't say specifically what they
were. Team building.
I don't want to get fired from work.
You got a raise.
I got a big old raise.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's good.
Yes, that's the good part.
You can take me to Disneyland now.
Disneyland.
Disneyland.
Disneyland. Is that Adam Sandler and...
It was Bulletproof.
Yeah, but which Wayans?
Damon Wayans.
Damon Wayans, yeah.
Yeah, I think that was... What was that, like...
The Last Boy Scout.
No, it was probably 98, 99 when that came out.
I'm not gonna... We're not gonna do this.
Why?
Because I don't want to get in an argument with you about the date.
Why?
Fine.
You want to just look it up?
Look it up.
Bulletproof came out late at 90s.
I play Pokemon. Do you know... I have two questions for you. I play Pokemon Go. I'm getting pretty good at that. It's almost as good as me. No, that's pretty bad.
Fuck you.
I have yet to see the 96. Spoof Elmo. 96. That's when I graduated.
Yeah, it was 96.
It explains why I didn't see it.
It was an earlier year or two earlier than I thought.
I saw it in like 2004. What'd you think?
You didn't even give me a year. You didn't even...
I told you I'm not going to do that because you're going to go, oh, yeah, I told you. We got an argument about that.
James Caan, is he dead yet?
James Caan. I don't know.
Jesus, he's old.
How does he talk?
Oh, he's only 70?
Well, that's old.
77.
That's real old.
He's 77.
He's fucking old.
My dad's 71.
Yeah, he'll he's be old 70. As shit. I'm
it's
sorry.
Not old as shit.
Yeah, he is. My dad's old.
How old is your dad?
1948.
Well, your dad's 2 years younger than me. He's not even 70 yet.
69.
He'll be
69?
70 next year.
My dad is 69.
Ooh. Groots. I play Pokemon Go every day. My old balls hang low.
Do you... Okay. I have two selfish things.
Hey, was it Rogue One? Did that come out on DVD this week or last week?
My friend...
It was a digital release last week.
Dude, you seriously just talked about something that goes right into what I was going to talk about.
Blowjobs.
Do you... Well, always. I'm going to talk about BJs and HJs and ZJs whenever I get the chance. But... Okay, so I have a guilty thing I do, and I don't want it to be like, now it sounds like I'm talking about BJs, but I don't want it to sound like I'm a real asshole, but I have to explain a couple of things that I do, and you have to tell me if it's like I'm just being completely unreasonable or people suck about it. Remember my old thing, how people suck about stuff? Well, I think people suck about four-way stops, big time.
I can tell you why.
Because they don't know how to do it.
They don't know pay attention when they come up to it. Nobody's paying attention when they stop. They don't pay attention.
I'm always paying attention. I'm angry. I'm angry before I stop there because I know they're going
to
fuck it up.
Pay attention to who gets there first.
That's not...
That's the biggest thing. They don't pay attention. They're like, they get there and they're like...
Look up the law.
The first one on the... Whoever's on your right.
Yeah, but if you all get there at the same time, then what?
You honk your horn and flash your titties.
Okay, let's say there's three people at a three-way stop. There's somebody on your left, there's you, and then there's somebody on your right. The third person, meaning the person on your right, should go first, right?
Yeah.
And then I don't mind if they're going straight and the other guy's going straight if they do that together. They engage together. That, to
Is
me...
Is that like docking?
No. They're just ejecting. It's more like ejecting.
Oh, okay.
They leave the stop signs at the same time. But something I can't fucking stand is if, okay, and we're going to go with that scenario, the three people, okay? Somebody on my left, me in the middle, somebody on my right. When I pull up to that stop sign, in my head, I am like, I want the guy on the right to just go first, okay? But sometimes they're like, they give you the wave. I always pretend like I don't see the wave the first time. If they wave at me twice, I angrily speed through the intersection. I don't want you to wave me through. I want you to do it right. And then, like, so that we don't all get in an accident. You know what I mean?
This happened on your way here?
Oh, my God. It happens every day. So I expect the guy on the right to go. Now, if he goes, I don't mind if the other guy goes. But I'm supposed to go next, right? It goes back the other way.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
So it goes from left to right, the right one being the first one to go, and then back around.
Clockwise.
Yep.
So please correct me if I'm wrong. But that's how I want to fucking do it. I don't mind if the person on my right goes, and then at the same, since he sees him moving, the one on my left goes too. They're
That's
going
fine.
The same way.
That wouldn't piss me off.
Nope, because it's practical and it's efficient. And it's fine. Then I'll just go and I'll be a happy fucking camper. But guess how often that happens? Never. First thing that happens is they hesitate. The guy on my right hesitates. And I'm like, immediately, I'm like, fuck you. go.
You know what?
Like, I don't. You're
when I'm in that
go.
Situation and somebody
I just
has
go.
Years, I fucking go. I don't think twice about it.
But
I fucking go.
I don't go if I'm to the left. I still wait angrily because I want to do it right. And I want them to fuck off, and I want them to drive their car with
the
brand.
You're so fucking passionate about this.
And then the guy on my left, then, so the guy slowly pulls out to the right, and he's halfway through the intersection. Takes about 10 seconds, and then he's off. He's roaring off in his Jetta, whatever. And then the guy
on my happened tonight.
It happens every day, dude. And the guy on my left, this happened tonight though, and this is the one that gets me.
He gets your goat.
Dude is halfway. His rear end
is on
your
right.
The guy on my right is halfway through the intersection, but his rear end is still in my lane. Finally, the guy on my left is like, oh, yeah, this is one of those instances where I could go at the same time. It's like, no, but it's not the same fucking time anymore. You've lost your opportunity. But then they go anyway, and you got to sit there and wait for this asshole because he didn't go at the same time as the guy across the street from him. That pisses me off. That's the one where I'm like, fuck, go crash. I want them to crash. I want them to swerve off to the right, and then a bus just like hits them, knocks them into the river bottoms. Do you think
a boulder falls from this mountain?
It might be, yeah.
Crushes the side of their car. It's pushes a little, the car into the river valley below.
That's a little Roadrunner-esque. Do you think
that's where Wile E. Coyote is right now?
And the Roadrunner, he's mad. Do you think he's mad at the Roadrunner or Wile E. Coyote?
Who's Steve?
Yeah.
The Roadrunner.
Yeah, I agree.
Oh.
So what, I mean, is that completely unreasonable?
No, I have a lot of traffic issues because I'm a very, I'm an aggressive driver, but not like speeding aggressive. I'm just like, oh, it's the left-hand lane people that fucking cruise in the left-hand lane that really irritate me.
Yep. They should be going at least.
And no matter how fast you're going, if you're in the left hand lane and somebody's coming up on you and you have a place to get over, then you should get over on your right hand lane no matter what.
Correct. You know? I agree. Yep, absolutely.
Doesn't matter how fast you're going.
It should be. You should be going. Here's my opinion, which I'm sure
still
lots of
should
people
get over.
There's plenty of people who disagree with us though. My opinion is this. If you're in the right lane and the speed limit is 55 miles an hour, you just be able to set your fucking cruise.
Yep.
55.
Yep.
And then if you're in the left lane, you should be going between 60 and 65 miles an hour. In the three lane situation, I'm talking about, not two.
Right.
If you're in the left lane and the two lanes go in the same direction, you should be going as fast as you need to go to get around that person and then let the guy behind you through. But in the three lane situation, the guy in the left lane should be like doing like 70, 75 miles an hour.
Right.
That's my
opinion.
Not
fucking cruising in the left lane at 55 miles an hour.
Correct. Or even 65. So
I think
this
should just be
65.
An educational podcast today about driving.
Well, the government has taken care of that with the classes people take to get their licenses.
Oh. No.
The government. Should we? Are you going to be, what happened? What did I just?
I had an Uber.
What did I trigger?
I had an Uber instance from to Minneapolis and back. I went out to Chris Ruth's Steakhouse.
Oh, Ruth's Chris Steakhouse.
Yeah, whatever. Fucking two first
sounds
names.
Awesome.
Anyways, my guy that was driving us out there.
Is it Ruth's apostrophe S Chris Steakhouse?
Yes.
That doesn't make any fucking sense.
I don't know.
Okay, go
on. I'm not even worried about the semantics of that.
Right,
fucking,
go
I don't
ahead.
Care. The guy that was driving us out there, he had glasses, and he was probably Wahib Mahab, or whatever his name was.
is that phonetically correct?
I'm going to just say both of my drivers were probably Middle Eastern on
right,
both roads.
At least Middle Eastern, Eastern African.
Yes. Oh, so, okay, so I have a problem with some of these guys. That
you can't say that, Lance.
Problem with these guys that get their license.
Okay.
Because they don't have a fucking shit care for anybody else that's on the goddamn fucking road.
you've gotten
this
taxes.
Guy is in the left hand lane. Okay, we're passing 280 on 94, right? You know, kind of curve.
That's scary. That whole road is scary.
So we're in the left hand lane, you know, and then 280 traffic comes back around like this. And you meet up with him, right?
I got you.
Well, he decides to like just hover in between the very left hand lane and the middle lane. So he's right in the middle of his van is going down the middle of the fucking line, right? Between probably 280 and like 5th Street exit.
Fuck you.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes, I do.
And there's this Impala next to us trying to like share or be in the middle lane.
Ooh, gangsters.
Yeah, and he was a black dude.
Hey, wait, what?
I was paying attention to this whole situation, right? Okay. It has nothing to do with him being black.
He's how it works.
He's how it works. And this, I felt bad for the dude in the Impala because the guy in the van is hovering in the middle between two lanes. And the guy in the Impala is
saying that he was black, by the way.
I'm just saying he was. I'm just making observations here.
Okay.
And he's honking at my fucking Uber driver, like, stay in your lane, motherfucker. And I'm like,
I agree.
And I'm going, yeah, stay in your lane, fucker. Stay in your lane. You know, like, I'm agreeing with the Impala. I'm like,
he's scaring
you. Yeah. And I'm fucking having a heart attack on the way out there because he's just like driving down the middle of the goddamn fucking lane.
Oh, my God.
So we get there and I'm like,
so did he not? How often did he do that?
How did he get his fucking license? Let alone how did he get his Uber fucking license?
Was it a one? I don't think your car needs to qualify and you have to pass a background check.
I asked somebody one
time. They're vetted better than Syrian refugees, actually.
What?
I'm just kidding.
So anyways, wondering how this guy fucking got his Uber. He just had no care for what he was doing in lanes. So we get there close by, probably like two blocks away.
I'm Detective John Kimball.
We probably get two blocks away, and he's like supposed to turn a corner and another corner to get there. I'm like, stop right here, just stop right here.
Fuck you, asshole.
Just stop right here and let us out. We're good right here. And I was done with him.
Please, let me off. Okay, here's the deal.
Okay, I'm not done.
What about your review? Did you give him a 1 star?
I gave him 2 out of 5.
How did he get 2 stars? You said you thought you were gonna die.
Anyways, dinner was done, right? On the way back.
Fuck me.
Sorry.
On the way back, I get another driver.
How does he get
riding the gas pedal on and off.
We'll talk about that later. Go on.
Same situation. Same kind of like Cracker Jack box license, kind of no care for what. I mean, this guy has got the heat on and he's fucking riding the gas pedal. So you're watching the RPMs. Shit. Watching the RPMs going up and down, going.
That's annoying. Wow. That's annoying.
I get sick. I'm getting fucking sick on the way back.
Were you? Because you're full of meat.
Full of meat, and this guy's going. I'm like, I go, just keep it steady. How about that, guy? Huh? Keep your fucking foot steady on the gas pedal.
Stop it.
I'm just watching the fucking RPMs. It's not the gas. It's not the brake pedal. He's just fucking.
Maybe his car had intake issues.
You're slightly doing this.
Right now the motion is he's moving his microphone back and forth like if you're rowing a boat.
Oh, let's add the warmth and the weird smell in his van.
That is total
bullshit.
Oh my God.
Add the warmth and the smell in there.
Okay, wait. So I have a question. This guy is literally feathering the pedal.
Whoa. Yeah, but it's not like that. It's more like.
Sure, he didn't just have a problem with like his map sensor or his air intake. Okay, I got you. He's trying to catch up.
To what?
I don't know. That's a good question. And you asked
how people.
Why am I still alive? Did you get in and like, hey, where are your seatbelts?
Those are the two bad fucking Uber rides I had. And you want to bitch about people at stop signs. These Uber guys were fucking horrible.
Trust me.
I did want to bitch about, you know what the.
You son of a bitch.
You know what? The four-way stop thing, I think. So I don't think we disagree then. You got to fucking do it right. Am I wrong for. Okay. But my question was when I'm sitting at the four-way stop kind of. Because I'll be mad at first and then I'll laugh because I shunned a wave through. Like they're like, you know, they give you the fucking Bruce Lee, like fingers come hither, like cross this lane. Yeah,
and then you gave him the fucking Chuck Norris back or what?
Yeah, I wish. I fucking wish my car would walk over there and kick him. But
kick him.
He kicks. So I.
Yeah.
Well, what do you expect?
Is it the computer?
It is. It's a loading thing. Okay, so here's the thing. I think then I laugh because I'm like, I basically just, this guy tried to do like a nice gesture. Like, hey, you know what, bro? I'll tell you what, I'm having a good day. I'm just going to chill here for an extra
two seconds,
three and a half seconds. Mm-hmm. Will you pull through that Will you pull through that intersection? I'm going to wave you through. And you know what? Don't hurry. I'm chilling. Just go on right through. And then I'm like, fuck you, you fucking asshole. And then I hide, like, hand up to the side of my face, look the other direction. And then you look back angrily and you're like, why aren't you going? And then that's bad, isn't it? That's just semantic anger right there.
There's a lot of road rage. I'm
then I have a road rage moment.
I'm a passenger road rager.
Oh, my wife makes me drive.
What do you mean? Stop doing it.
Yeah, I'm going to stop. She makes me, she go the other day, she's like, do you want me to drive or you want to drive? You better drive. I'm like, why do you want me to drive? And it was a stupid question because she goes, because you get pretty anxious when I drive. You get angry. I'm like, oh. And then I'm at the point in my life now where I am, I like know myself well enough. And I'm like, oh, I'm such an asshole. I'm like, okay, I'll drive, baby.
You realize it, but you don't realize it at the
I
same
do,
time.
I realize it, but then I know that if I got in the passenger side of that car within 10 minutes, I'd be doing the same thing. So I'm like, you know what? You're right. Thanks, honey. You are truly my wife. You're like, you know what? We're just going to avoid this situation, asshole. You drive.
So you like that all the time now?
No. She still drives sometimes, but I just, that day, I think she was
horse
like,
and buggy.
It's a good day. Let's not fuck this up. Get in the driver's seat.
What if three horse and buggies pulled up to an intersection at the same time? Who goes first?
I don't know, but all I want to see at that point, I'm not going to be angry. What I'm doing in my head is I'm betting. Okay, which horse, which set of horses, when they first get the chug along, is going to drop a couple fucking road balls down? You know what I mean? A couple of big horse turds? You know, because they do that when they take off. Like, they're like, they get their tail up, and then they give a little kick to get past the poop, you know?
Yeah.
And they drop the poop on there.
How's that go?
I play Pokemon Go every day. I play Pokemon Go. Yowza. That's my Guns N' Roses.
I was on Oakdale. And what's that? Was that Marie where Target runs up to? Is it Marie? It's probably Marie.
It starts with an L.
No, it's Marie.
Okay.
It's Lothenbach or something like
Lothenbach,
that.
Lothenbach, yes. And then Marie is one block down with the Culvers.
Girl in a white Cavalier. Two of the tires are like this full. Smoke coming out of the engine. Smells like just burning up. And just...
Girl, you'll be out of oil soon.
Just no care in the world. Car's about to just shit on her. She's on her phone.
Dad's gonna
She's on her phone just fucking doing her thing. I'm looking at the car. I'm like, honey... You're going to be on the side of the road in about 2 seconds or in the middle of somebody's way in the road.
And then you see the look on her face and you know that if you called her honey, she'd be like, fuck you, I'm not your honey.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, so were you leering at her?
No, I'm just looking at her.
Well, that's appropriate, then.
Just going, she went, like, I'm going this way up Lothenbach or Marie or whatever, and she's going to Oakdale towards Southview. She passes me. And I'm just like, you know, like that. I'm like, what the fuck is going on with that car?
Driving on Lothenbach in
I wouldn't bring that thing from South St. Paul to Invergrove Heights, let alone.
Yeah, and you can literally cross the street and get it. You might have to push it back.
Booyah!
Bitch. Get off the street. Get off the street with that.
So we got a pretty good weekend coming up here, Adam.
That's second on my list.
Chicago.
Hold on. But I got to say something.
What?
This... Okay, so
we need to get back to. Oh, I feel so weird.
We're gonna get back to Chicago, but what you said something about.
No, I was talking about doing podcasts. Like, it feels so weird having a week off and getting back into it.
Yeah, we should do it every week.
No, I know. I'm just saying, like, getting back into the role of things. You know, you need to, like, consistently do it too. And I'm not saying we did it on purpose. I'm just saying it was
right. It wasn't my fault.
It's just a feeling I'm having right now.
Yeah. It's fine. Do I
do girl,
it?
Girl, you'll be a woman soon.
We should play that in the background
real quick.
She's not your kind.
Oh. Anyway, Chicago. Adam and I are venturing to Chicago this Saturday.
Guess why?
Morning. To watch UFC fights.
That's not the main reason.
No. We are going to go to the House of Rock in Chicago Sunday evening to watch our boys in Periphery perform.
Mm-hmm. I'm just going to do a little background banana shit.
Yeah.
I don't know if they have.
Icarus Lives. That's a really good one.
Oh, you know what? To really show their full
down
balance.
No, Icarus.
Hang on, watch this song. Let's do both. I'm going to turn it down and we'll just listen to it in the background.
Ari Gold? Official music video.
It's got to be, right?
I'll turn it down now.
Well, here, I can just, I got it. Just let me do it
and then I'll turn it up.
This is a really cool video, too. So, this shows, like, their versatility.
Yeah, because the listeners can see that.
Well, the song shows the versatility, the way it sounds. Turn this part up. Get ready to get fucking rock.
Boom. One of the best songs on the album.
It is. And it's definitely my favorite. It is, like, 8 minutes long.
No, it's five.
I'm willing to bet you dollars. Five. It is 7 minutes and, like, 40
turn
seconds
on
long.
The thing.
The video is 5 minutes, but on the album, it's like 7 minutes and 40 seconds long.
The chorus is what makes this fucking song. And this riff is cool.
Yeah, it's absolutely awesome. This video is really good, though. Did you watch it ever?
I've seen it.
Sounds really good, too.
Everything's well balanced.
Fuck, man. They do such a good job.
Excited to see these guys?
No, I've been listening to this album nonstop. I gotta go back and listen to Omega and Alpha and
we'll listen to the first part of
the
chorus.
Clear? It's Clear the other album?
Yeah, it was a self-release kind of thing.
Still very good. But this is their best.
This chorus
all
is
around.
The best.
This is saving. Is this song about old people?
No, it's about having time.
I think it's about getting older.
Maybe.
Pushing daisies.
True. Definitely has to deal with time.
I'm watching the video now. I'm wrapped.
All right, that's good.
I like that. I like when he does, and then we'll just go in the background with the other one you talked about. Something to
just
do
hit back on the browser. Yeah, it's on there. And then scroll down.
I don't want to lose my history.
Scroll down.
Oh, wait. I need one more back.
Yeah. Yeah, you do.
Yeah, so.
It was on there. Down. Right there. Icarus Lives.
Blind. Okay.
Yep.
Is this the right one, do you think?
Well, they were on Roadrunner?
Huh.
They've always been on Sumerian.
Maybe it's a different thing here. You guys, KFC is sponsoring this episode of The Flummery, which is episode 16.
Yeah, welcome to episode 16.
Motherfudges. Oh, that was...
The intro is awesome. I'm going to turn it down.
Yeah, we'll leave it. We'll just kind of let it roll. So we're going to see Periphery in Chicago, the House of Fucking Blues.
Who's opening up for him?
I don't remember. Why do the doors open at 3:30 p.m.? They tried to sell me a dinner combo with the tickets.
What the fuck?
I was like,
we
no.
had a Chan Hassen dinner theater or what?
It seems like, yeah, a movie cafe. It's welcome to the movie cafe.
So who's opening up for him?
I don't know. I should look.
Isn't it Contortionist?
Is anyone opening?
Oh, so Cold Kingdom's at the House of Rock this weekend in San Diego.
San Diego.
They're playing two nights there.
You know what I'm kind of
upset
about?
Is it tonight
or
tomorrow?
Tonight and tomorrow, I think.
Is it?
Okay, you need to look up both of them then.
No, it's just we need to talk.
Yeah, I'm going to say fuck that. Look up, though. Marigold is 7 minutes long.
Have you experienced Chicago before, my friend?
I have relatives in Chicago. I have had the Chicago experience. Yeah. My uncle and my cousins lived in Chicago. My aunt, Rita... And rest her soul. Beautiful woman. Fun and strict. But anyway, I don't
like wait. She'll put three fingers in your ass and then slap you across the face with
that's
it.
That's not appropriate. I think that she's very religious.
Do your chores.
She was religious, but she was very practical. You know what I mean? Like she was very practical and religious. So it's kind of a good mix. But yeah, so she passed away long after we grew up. You know, but when we were there, it was, you know, her, my Uncle John, and my cousins, and we would get, I mean, we went to the aquarium, we went everywhere. John took us a few times, like, just by himself, like, yeah, I'm gonna take all the kids into the city, because they lived in a suburb of Chicago. So, yeah, I've done the whole thing, but me and the wife and my brother and sister-in-law took a trip to Chicago a few years ago, I think after our first child, and before the second. And we actually at Bar Gibson's, we hung out there for a bit.
Not familiar.
It's the, have you ever seen The League?
No.
It's the bar that they're always in.
Oh. That doesn't mean it's
or cool they made a set to. That looks exactly, well, it's, when we were in there, we're on vacation, so I'm just, you know, jeans, t-shirt type of deal. Everybody else is, you know, in a tie and stuff. You can tell that's why they have it in the, because their jobs, you know, are in downtown Chicago. And I'm like, yeah, I'm a little underdressed for this, but there was some chicks you'd probably see, like, you know, some very affluent women in there that you can think are pretty powerful women.
Yeah.
Kind of the kind of chicks you might be like, you could probably rock your world pretty good. They're pretty hot.
Yeah.
And you could tell they're like powerful, confident. I'm just like, ooh. I'm just looking and keep looking to my wife like, don't catch me.
Catch me if
there
you
were
can.
Some hot
catch
hot
me outside.
Chicks,
how about
there.
It?
But yeah, it was fucking really really good drinks, though.
Yeah. Like, oh. I was there 2 years ago with the B-52 crew boys.
Really?
Yeah. And part of that was a business trip for Mark on...
I'm going to stop this.
Kind of a...
Okay.
It was a business trip to just hit YouTube.
Yep. Gotcha. So, anyway.
It was a business trip to check out different burger joints.
Oh, yeah.
So, it was like a referencing kind of trip. So we all like did it. We all went and tried different burgers around town, like from anywhere from Lincoln Park down to fucking wherever we were.
Oh, that's pretty. I didn't even know that part.
What?
That's why you were there. I heard about the trip.
Well, it was for fun, but part of it was to like experience different burgers. So
yeah, that's awesome.
So B-52s could kind of like compare and contrast to what they had going on to what was going around, you know, like in the Chicago area. Not that Chicago's like a huge burger place. I mean, they're known for their deep dish pizzas more than anything.
I bet they've got some really magnificent burgers.
Oh, they do. They don't get me wrong.
I see. It's periphery and sonic unrest, too.
So, what do you mean?
No. I'm sorry. That's the name of the show. It is The Contortionist.
Yeah, The Contortionist.
Norma Jean and Infinity Shred.
Have you seen The Contortionist yet?
No, I've heard them, though. You played them for me several times, and I really, yeah, I can dig on that. For a while. Why do the doors open at 3:45?
Because it's an all-ages show, probably.
I don't think so. I think it's because they have the dinner first. Why are they doing that?
Go to the dinner.
Sunday at 3:45 p.m. No.
Go to. You should, you know, well, as long as we're out.
We need to find out, like, what time the good
we'll
part
find
of the
out.
Show starts.
Do,
who do we ask?
Do the contortionist causality.
Oh, right here?
Yeah.
All right. But yeah, we're going to watch UFC in Chicago.
Yeah, Saturday night. Well, it's not going to take up our whole night. It's going to take like 3 or 4 hours.
We should go to Bar Gibson then and watch it.
Is that by our place?
I think so. Well, it's it's right in the middle of everything. We walked from the Viagra.
There's another northeast district. That's
what
like
am I looking up?
The contortionist. Causality.
Yeah, so we were north of there at the
there's a hip bar district in the north.
It's called the Viagra Triangle, where old people go to meet young chicks.
Yeah,
not even kidding. I learned that there from somebody who like worked at one of the bars.
Top one.
Yeah.
So these guys are. You guys haven't listened to Contortionist.
How far
these
is
guys
our
are
hotel
a little
from
bit
the-
more. Jazzy meets
chill.
Prague. No, not this isn't chill.
I think it's pretty chill. Do you know? Okay, so when you say where we're staying at is right by the
we're a couple,
House of Blues, right?
Yeah, probably a block or two away
from him. Yeah, so I think Gibson is close to there. It's on Michigan Avenue, I think. But I remember... What is the... We were in, like, the financial district, and we're walking down the street, and I'm like, you guys stop for a second and look. Everybody looks. Like, what's your deal? And I'm like, just look. Every building has giant concrete pillars, and they're all dressed up, you know, with, like, you know, the rock, layered rock, and, like, and then they've got a, you know, a couple of circles around them, and then there's, like, the top. It's like a pedestal, you know. And, but every building has their own, like... has their own group of pedestals in front of the building. And I'm like, Jesus, you know what that's for?
AIDS patients.
It's not for the AIDS patients. They could get through, like, in between the pillars.
Yeah.
But their pillars, they're all, like, 3 feet tall.
Yeah. For people on wheelchairs.
No, they're fucking...
clink, clink. Damn it, Martha, I can't get through. Just push me, Tom, push me.
No, it's so fucking... Somebody can't ram a fucking explosive vehicle into the place.
And wheelchairs.
It has, because everyone had it.
It's for people that have disabilities that can't get in.
To keep the disability people out. Well, they are heartless financial companies that we're talking about here, so I completely can see that. Fucking pigs. Yeah, they don't want anybody in there that can move around mobily without using their legs, because it's too convenient for them. But no, honestly, that I guarantee you that's why. How about it's a fucking zoning thing, like, for safety? I would be willing to bet money on that.
And people in wheelchairs. Stephen Hawking tried to go there one time.
He's like, fuck you, I can fly.
I cannot get through your pillars.
And then he just uses his mind to beam himself upstairs. Like, I figured...
Oh, he
dude, he's like this. He sits there...
He's a remote...
Clicking away for a while, and then he goes... And then he goes, fuck you, now I can fly. And then he just flies up there.
You know he remote views anyway from his chair.
He's like, I already know what we're going to talk about today.
I've already flown to the center of Saturn.
It's not in a dream.
There is a core.
Fuck you, dear fucking pussy.
There is life in our solar system. Underneath the ices of Europa.
He's in trouble for sexual harassment. He's like, he was like, he typed it in, but the thing got it wrong. He was like, touch me.
There was a joke by some guys like,
touch me, touch my penis.
How he left his wife being in a wheelchair.
I saw like the biography, so I know what really happened, but what's the joke?
Oh, I wish I could remember it.
He was like, I'm going to stop giving you that good dick.
Oh, no, it's like, she's like, he's like, oh, so he's sitting there, right? Listen.
Okay.
She says something like, so I guess this isn't just working out. We tried whatever, honey. He's just like.
Okay. And then, yeah, he gets the, when he looks at you that way. I'm like, this is good. This should be on the video right now. You've got the facial expressions down.
Like he's typing something, you know?
Yep, we got it. Why you know?
And then it goes on for a
while. Don't break the fourth wall when you're in character.
Yeah. He looks up and he goes, well, in this case, you win some and you lose some.
Well, in this case, you win some and you lose some. And then it was like, he accidentally put in his macro for the thing, but the thing always says it wrong. Touch it. Touch my penis. Touch my penis real good. Sorry, honey. That was a mistake. That was a typo. Oh, man.
I can't get up out of my wheelchair, but I can get this all up inside of you.
You're about to get that good D.
He had 3 kids.
Yeah, man. Well, it was before he was in the wheelchair.
Well, he was...
You know, he was... He ended up... What does he have? Is it MS?
Yeah.
So he ended up... He was totally fine for a
cool song.
Yeah, it was by the very way. Good.
It's one of my favorite songs. Okay, just YouTube the top of it.
I got you. YouTubes. Back YouTube. To YouTubes.
Yeah, so I'm excited to see these. This will be like my fourth or fifth time seeing these guys now.
It will be
the problem is with the problem with the contortionists. They're just not very palatable for a lot of people.
Really? Why?
Because they're very proggy.
Balls. Well,
there's not like verse, chorus, verse, chorus,
that's
verse.
That's the problem
chorus.
With, you know, the saying? Fucking music industry.
I'm saying this, they don't do verse, chorus things. There's no, like, you know what I'm saying?
That's how people fall. Yes, I do. To acknowledge what you're saying, yes, I get it, and I agree. But a lot of times I'm listening to a song and I'm like, okay, three verses and three choruses, great. So that's what we like is way different than what a lot of other people like. Not way different in the sense that there's good music.
I love that Periphery loves the shit out of the Contortionists and gets what they're doing.
Really?
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah. Misha talks about them all the time. He's like, I love these guys. They're one
See,
of my
I
favorite.
Can't do that. I can't remember their names and shit like that.
Cool.
Anybody. I used to remember, you know, all the band names, all the song names, all the lyrics, all the, you know. Oh, and then they were with this band, and there was these guys. Oh, their Europe album. It's
See,
like,
that's what
I can't
this,
do it.
This realm, I gave up on that stuff for a long time. But when this realm of music came back into my life and became a thing, and now it's fucking blowing up. Like, I'm giving a shit about
it's
music
good.
Again. You know?
It is good. So your job, you've got 5 days to do it. Since you've met them, and I'm sure they'll remember you. You're gonna get us backstage with Periphery.
I can't. I mean,
just Facebook them, farts book them.
I've talked to Misha several times. I've sat in their van, but they don't. They're not going to remember me. Like
PM him with a picture of your butthole.
I've talked to him on Messenger before, but I'm not going to pull that shit.
Just say it's for a friend. That'll go good.
I'm not like that. I don't like doing that shit.
Wondering how I get backstage. .. for a friend. Just send it. Here, I'll send
see,
it
look
for
at,
you.
Look at Misha and I've had several conversations.
Misha. Misha Mora. Oh.
We've talked.
That's cool. I don't know who that is.
That's
it could be anybody.
That's a guitar player from Periphery. one of the three. He's the dark skinned one.
The three play guitar, but.
He's the dark skinned one.
Yeah. He's like. Is he like Hawaiian or something?
No, he's like Samoan? Fucking Kuwaitan or something like that.
You think so?
Yeah, he's like something like that. He's pretty close
more
to that area.
Like, I was thinking more like island life.
I don't know.
Like
he's Middle Eastern.
Okay. Well, I guess it makes sense. His name is Misha. So.
He's Jewish too.
It's a different Misha though, not to be confused with our friend who loves.
I love Pokemon Go.
That thing that we're doing now is such a treat for everybody that gets to listen to us. I'm sure of it.
He should have opened up for Eric's at the Fineline.
It has evolved. It is Eric's now.
Our new band's
amending Eric's. We'll be amending the flyers soon. Oh, man.
I play Pokemon Go.
Okay, so I have another question for you.
Yeah, you got something for me?
Okay, so this goes into and why I brought up the whole traffic stop thing was I was thinking about that today, and I think about it all the time. But because I'm an angry person. What is your take? Because we were talking about Rogue One, and it reminded me that a friend of mine bought Rogue One on their Amazon Prime, like right when it came out. And we were hanging out for my son's birthday, and on the way out, you know, their family's leaving. And on the way out, he's like, oh, hey, and I totally forgot, but he's like, hey, I bought Rogue One on Amazon Prime, so you can watch that tonight. And I was like, fuck you, what? Okay, that's sweet. What are you talking about? I can watch it. And I remember that we're stealing their Amazon Prime. We're stealing their Amazon on our TV. And Amazon has to, it's in two different states. They live in Hudson, Wisconsin.
Yeah, weird.
And then I'm starting to think about today, I'm like, am I being obnoxious about the four-way stop? And then I start to think about other things I'm particular about. And then I'm like, oh, but I'm perfectly willing to steal Amazon and give away my Netflix account.
We share we share our internet with Steve. Steals our internet.
Oh, that's cool.
Hey, Steve, just have our password. You have some wireless.
Yeah,
got awesome. That. Now you're moving on us. Take that with you, too.
He has to.
It's okay. He doesn't listen anyways.
We. Fuck you, Steve.
Fuck you, Steve.
But I made him promise, which he never promised me, but I've texted him several times that I'm going to make him promise to build us a studio in his basement.
Yeah?
Yeah. So we have two.
Yeah, why not?
And then when I redo my basement, I don't have to put a studio in mine, but I will.
I wonder, he didn't tell me where he's moving to.
It's not far. It's about 20 minutes away.
Like
I don't know if he's supposed to.
South,
supposed to
east,
say.
What? I don't get what this secrecy is about. It's really pissing me off.
I don't think it's secret. He told me right
before,
off the
before
bat.
It was. I know he's like, nah, bah, bah, bah. It's all over.
Now everybody walk a bah. You know what I mean? Walk a bah.
Keep it a secret. No, I can tell everybody
secret,
now.
Secret, a secret
Jesus,
household.
Make up your fucking mind.
Do you? Okay, so it's in Prescott, I think.
Is it?
I think so. South of the river.
Makes sense.
It's a fucking nice area.
Yeah.
I would love to live
Makes
there.
Sense for him and Sandy, because that's kind of... She used to live in Hastings, outside of Hastings.
Is her last name... Vagina? We're not supposed to talk about her in the first place.
His roommate.
No, I'm calling his roommate Sandy Vagina. Well, here's what I want you to do. It seems like you're having a rough day. I want you to go over there and wash out the sand from your vagina that you piled deep inside your body earlier today.
You talking about me?
No, it's my speech to anybody with sand in their vag.
Oh.
Hey, Sandy, is it vagina? Are you? How's your day going?
Wow, where are you going with this?
I'm just throwing it out there because I think Sandy Vagina is a funny joke.
Oh.
Yeah, so how do you feel about that? Me stealing the interwebs and the Amazons.
You're fucking criminal.
Is it criminality 101?
I don't know. I guess I wouldn't feel good about myself.
Really?
Mm-mm.
Fuck. It's that bad?
No, it's each to each his own person. You know,
well, I'm wondering because normally I stand on principle on a lot of stuff.
Apparently not this one.
Oh, this is so fucking easy.
That went right out the door.
It's just easy.
That was a boulder falling from a mountain onto a car going into the river below.
Basically, you're right. It's just gravity doing its work. That's how I felt about it when I signed up. This funny part is, I shit you not, I have an Amazon Prime account.
That you pay for?
Yes. For the last month, I've had one. And I'm still stealing his Amazon.
Now
I have to use his Amazon because I want to watch Rogue One. I don't want to buy it.
You can get in there on
Fuck Disney.
I don't know. I'm going to buy the hard copy, I think.
Yeah, well, that's pretty fucking sweet.
I almost
sweet.
Bought it on Microsoft, and I was like, oh, maybe I should just go get the hard copy.
Get Rogue One on Microsoft.
And back in 1973, Bill Gates invented Microsoft. Pull that up. Let's do some fucking Steve Brule.
Should we?
Yeah.
All right. So you're on the, like, I'm, for you, you're going to push the button that injects me from the syringes, the three-part cocktail that kills me on the table.
What are you talking about?
Lethal injection for me because I'm a criminal about the Netflix and the Amazon. Yeah, I paid for Netflix for years.
I don't think that's a grounds for ending a life.
Now, make up your mind. Sweet berry wine.
Do that.
Okay, I'm there.
Hey, Jenny. Wait. Do the 256 one.
I don't know. Like, I don't know what's more funny, the Brule or the fucking only married news team. And they're so gross.
I know they are. Do the second one.
This one?
Yes.
That's 3 minutes.
So what?
Here. This one's only a minute. That's why is it shorter?
No, it's not going to show. No, because... No, you got to do the 256 one.
All right, fuck it.
And now the only married news team in the Tri-County
area. Married, that's Bob Odenkirk.
Yeah. Skyler. With special news correspondent
Saul Goodman.
Steve Brule.
I love all kinds of drinks, and especially wine.
Well, that makes one of us because I can't even get near the stuff because of my interior rash.
This might not
the
be
red wine is the worst for my sores.
Interior rash.
I didn't know that, Jan.
Well.
Why didn't you say something when I poured you a glass last night?
He's got a pencil on goatee.
Oh, what a treat. We've got a very special guest. Dr. Steve Brule is up in wine country. He's going to show us a thing or two about the differences between different kinds of wine.
Steve? Hey, Jenny. Hey, Wayne. I don't even like wine.
Yeah, those names are on.
Guess what? You're going to like it. I need some cheese.
Steve, what kind of wine is that you're drinking? I can't see, hon.
Sweet berry wine.
Holy shit. He just cans it.
I'm supposed to spit it out.
So he's got wine running
no
down his face.
No way, Jose. Am I spitting this stuff out? It tastes like fruit. Wine was invented
sweet berry
by
wine.
Romans for orgies. And orgies are not too much fun if no one wants to do with you.
Mike, you want to check on Steve real quick?
Tell him how it tastes, Steve.
He just cuts him off.
Let's do it.
Steve?
Steve, are you okay over there?
There's all kinds of other wines.
Peanut Nor?
You got all different kinds, and that's our Steve rule. For your wine. All
right.
Come here, Jenny.
Jenny.
If you guys don't know who Steve Rule is, you need to get on it. It's fucking John C. Reilly in his best character ever.
It's better if you see the videos too, though.
Yeah, I have to see the videos. You can't just don't.
I'm good. Not. Yeah, so we love Steve Rule. He's a big fan.
He's
of ours.
My favorite character in a long time. Like he's like one of my top fucking craziest, weirdest fucking character.
I think so.
Do this. Do one more. Do the Michael Soft.
For sure.
Brule's rules.
Yeah, I'm Brule on cool.
No, top one.
Is it? Are you sure? Wait. Okay, let's do it.
Oh, no.
Hey, yeah, offer some tips about computers. This has to be it. This is it.
Hi, I'm Dr. Steve Brule with Wouldn't That Be Cool? In 1971, Bill Gates invented Microsoft. Wouldn't it be cool if I could remember my dingus password for my email? That would be cool.
Fucking right into the microphone, I swear. Cracks me up, man. Steve Brule. Steve Brule. Hey, you know what? I have... I do have to say something.
Say it.
Well, I don't have to say it. I wrote it down. So now I feel like I have to say it. I went to Menards today. First of all, I got the wrong thing, of course. Every time you go the first time, you get the wrong thing. So I thought I'd upgrade something, and I bought something that was cooler. It turned out to be a giant piece of shit. So I went back and got the old thing. It's just a switch, just a light switch. Okay, the guy that sells cable at Menards fucking... totally pisses me off. Whoever fucking decided that was a good idea is a total butt fucking idiot. And
cable, like watching cable on
like direct TV. Yeah. Oh yeah. Sorry. Not cable for like
your cable for like
electrical.
Right.
No, they've got this thing and every weekend they do a promotion, get a guy in there selling cable and then he walks around talking to everybody. And it's like, no,
that's an outside company doing that.
Yeah, but Menards lets them do it. I know they do. They have a contract with them. It's like, why would you make that contract?
Ramona, our singer, used to do that at like Walmart.
Oh, God, I bet she hated it.
She's trying to find her life right now, and she's done a lot of weird stuff in the last 2 years.
She's pretty cool. She'll be fine.
I was like, really? You're going to do it? You're going to do that job? And then it didn't last long. I'm like, oh, see? Duh.
I guarantee you she hated it. Did she hate it?
She's not there anymore. She wasn't there very long.
They're trying to... You're just doing like... Who signs that contract? Like, this is what we want in our store. Is some guy walking around harassing you about... Everybody's already got cable. Everybody does. That's why they're trying to make it a utility. Everybody's fucking got it. And it's $180 for everyone. Fuck you. Leave me alone. I'm trying to buy a tuber for. Okay. I'm done.
Can you tell me about your four-way stops again?
It's, you know what? It's times like these that makes me want to pull out a lottery ticket. Don't be like that.
No, you can't scratch off on that table anymore because I wiped it off last time. I sat there for a week and it fucking went into the crevices and it took me a little while to get it off.
A chemical reaction?
Yeah, from the water. Trying to wipe it off from the fucking cleaner.
You know what? I purposely did not bring the lottery tickets because it's not funny unless there's somebody here with me enjoying me.
Fuck you, Steve.
Enjoying me tormenting you. Steve and Jason get it. They got it. And I loved tormenting you.
Kill people.
Oh, for fun. I kill a motherfucker for fun. I'm getting a beer. Take it away now.
Grab me
Careless my, Whisper.
Grab me my Coors Light in the box.
No problems, guy.
So what time do you want to leave Saturday morning there, bud?
9 o'clock. You're fucked.
What do you mean I'm fucked? You're driving.
Yeah.
We'll take my vehicle. You're driving.
Because, mm-hmm. All right, it's because.
Should we listen? Should I have the new Mastodon album for a drive now?
Listen. What? I'm the guy who has like, hey, you know, like Mastodon, right? And you're like, yeah, whatever. And
what do you mean? Huh? I'm a fan of Mastodon. I've been listening to Mastodon. I
know that, but when I mentioned them one time, a long time ago, you're like, yeah, they're cool, but you know, blah, blah, blah. And you know, you're doing your own thing too. So, but I'm almost over Mastodon.
Really?
They haven't. Okay. When they came out, I'm like, oh, I can't believe these guys are mainstream. That's awesome. Cause it's like what we talk about. None of the good shit, the real innovative shit is mainstream anymore, you know, because it doesn't make them enough money or whatever the reason. Well, I was like, these guys are really fucking good.
They're mainstream. They still have choruses and verses. They still do that. They just approach it differently.
Not quite as much.
Yeah, they do. They have poppy shit. They do have poppy shit. You listen to The Hunter, that's very more poppy.
Well, it's very good, too. It's better than
a lot of the poppy build to that album. Oblivion is totally, which is off of Crack in the Sky. That's a fucking one of my favorite songs.
It is very good.
It still has a verse, chorus, verse, chorus, verse, chorus. First, pre-chorus, chorus. It does, because fucking Brand sings the verse.
Yeah.
And then fucking Troy, the bass player, sings the pre-chorus. And then Brent sings the chorus, and they do it like two or three times.
Huh.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess I get now that I'm thinking about it. It is like that. But
yeah, it is very.
They do break off at the end of the songs. They do have better intros and outros, though, than other chorus, verse, chorus type things, you know?
Right.
They have like a longer outro, you know, which makes it kind of like I guess, what would you call that? Not a breakdown, but it's just a.
They kind of do what Metallica's done.
Yeah, it's not. I think the sound is different.
It's just darker.
It's messier. It's
messier, darker.
Metallica's pretty dark. Kill 'Em All. Like those albums, Ride the Lightning, Kill 'Em All, and One, they're very dark. They're all about
Injustice for All, death, very dark.
Oh, yeah. Injustice for All, and then, of course, why am I thinking it's called Battery?
That's off of Master of Puppets.
Thank you, Master of Puppets. And I'm in trouble for laugh snorting? No, that
I'm,
was.
I'm getting fucking, you back. I did it on purpose.
Did. Oh, my God. I hate it. And I'm about to make a joke, and I can't remember a name again.
Good. Freeze up, motherfucker.
Did Atreyu just wake up?
Atreyu!
Let's fly.
It's a great movie.
One of my all-time favorites. Yeah. Top 10, top 5.
You still fall asleep and masturbate to it, don't you?
No. I stopped masturbating to it because I was starting to fall in love.
With Atreyu?
Yeah.
You wanted a feathery...
I wanted it to be like more of a friend's thing.
Atreyu had like dog hair mixed with like feathers.
This is what you're doing right now is basically sacrilege about that movie.
Why?
Because it was like a kid's movie.
Do a Atreyu meme.
How did you read my mind on that?
Do a meme.
You think?
Yeah.
Oh, you mean a vine?
Or like a meme or something.
All right, we'll try that. Oh, it's just a clip. And then a bunch of the stuff from the band.
There's different Atreyus, too.
Atreyu is a decent band. They're a little gimmicky, too. No, we can't. All right, we're not going
to
do that.
No, you're going to have to look up the Neverending Story, like memes.
Yeah, but you should be talking about something else while I do it.
Like butthole sex?
Sure.
Are you a giver or a taker?
No, I don't do butthole sex.
No?
No.
Okay.
I don't want to get AIDS again. Falcor gone wild? I'm afraid to play.
Falcor is a pervert. Wait, Atreyu's the fucking kid.
Yeah.
Falcor is the fucking dog.
Yeah, you're right. Yep, I think you're right.
I am right.
It's the theme. Just not have it been in the background. Just have it in the background. So, yes. Does somebody?
Can we do something else? Okay, well, we're gonna have this and talk over this.
Yes,
this movie is great. And the other one I want to do is fucking legend with Tom Cruise and the fucking Tangerine Dream or whatever.
I don't understand why.
You know that song I'm talking about?
Yes, but why did you like that movie?
I love that movie. It's horrible. Why is it horrible? It's fucking.
It's like Willow, where it's.
How is it horrible? The fucking devil was the coolest fucking thing in that movie.
I don't know.
Tim Curry played the devil.
It's a little fucked up for kids, first of all.
It was dark as shit, man.
I know.
So why is it bad?
Why'd you get a stallion? Never ending story. Because it wasn't for kids. It was like some weird shit, dude.
I don't understand why you don't like it. I think it's cool as shit. It's dark as shit. It's fucking. It was done very well.
I don't know about that.
What do you mean?
I bet it doesn't hold up that great, special effects wise.
It's better effects than this.
You think so?
Yes.
This looks pretty good though with the snail.
You need to rewatch Legend.
Look at the rock guy.
You need to rewatch Legend.
I haven't seen that for 20 years. I don't know why I would like take the time.
Would you watch it one night with me?
I can slumber party Legend with you, then yes, I will.
I'm being serious.
I'll watch Legend with you, but we could watch something way better.
No, you need to come back and watch.
I'd rather watch Stargate with you.
No, I already watched that recently. You got to watch. Movie. We're talking about Legend.
I know.
You're knocking on it, and I fucking love it.
And I'm trying to not have to watch it. I didn't like it.
This is where he loses horse.
Oh, man. That's the worst.
It is.
Yeah, that's pretty dark. Fucking horse dies in the... God.
The nothing.
Oh, I'm going to fucking cry.
Is that
cry.
What it's called?
I'm going to cry. And then he almost doesn't survive.
Oh, that effects were way good. Did you see that wolf?
It was very good. Almost as good as Silver Bullet.
See, he's got feather scales.
It's awesome. It's the best dragon ever. Oh, remember, is that where 300 got that? Did they steal it from Neverending Story?
Steal what?
When,
don't rewind it.
When he stabs the wolf jumps out of the darkness and he stabs him?
Mm-mm, I don't know. Was there a wolf in 300?
Yeah, at the beginning, that's how they, like, test.
Legend's better than 300.
Well, I'm sure there's lots of people who would argue with you about that.
Nice teacups.
You're chattering!
She's hot. That?
Don't.
She's hot.
She's like fucking 12.
Fucking 12. She's like fucking 12.
Dude, she's old enough right now. Trust me, she's old enough. Right
yeah, now she's like 48.
She's probably older than I am.
I know. But that doesn't mean when she's 12 in the movie, you call her hot. It's
but
okay.
What? Who cares?
That's like the guys who are like, I can't wait till Britney Spears is 18.
Never said that.
I know, but that's this exact same thing as what you're doing.
She's about our age, too, anyways.
That is a good fucking
song. All right, now do.
That's a good theme song.
Legend
all right.
Montage.
Tangerine Dream.
Yeah, there it is.
Balls.
I love this song.
Been kissed by the sun.
Or whatever. Love by the sun.
It's.
Love by.
Dude, that.
This song is not very good.
What do you mean it's not very good?
Just keep it in the background. I'm just.
Dude, I would write a song like this.
He would. Well, it'd be better now because people would be like, why is he writing this? It's so retro.
This is what I want to do. Like this, what you heard earlier tonight.
This is like the softcore porn version.
I want to do that, and then I want to do songs like this.
Or the Top Gun.
Like the airy, you know, the airy fucking.
What's the Top Gun theme song? This is the softcore version of that.
Oh, wait.
Tom Cruise is so hot.
I think it's the same fucking
Lily.
I, Lily, have not seen this movie in a long time. Well, I tell you what.
It's very 80s sounding, isn't it?
Yes. Okay, so I have a question. Do you care about the final tonight that's happening right now? I'm going to check the score.
Basketball,
yeah.
That's a silly question.
College basketball. Well, I know you don't. Oh, yeah. So.
Forever. By the sun.
One thing I will say about. I'm trying to ignore this.
By the sun.
Pokemon Go. Do you? No, on a serious note, I have to say something.
Oh, yeah, say it.
So I listen to a lot of like radio announcing of sports because I work second shift, and I watch them on replay, like the cables, televisions. The guy, my favorite announcer ever, now he has become legend for me, is Kevin Kubler. And
Kevin Keebler from the Keebler Elves?
No, Kevin Kubler.
I love fucking
Kevin Kubler.
I love those cookies.
Here at the Final Four, Kevin Kubler. He does it. He not only is he great at announcing the games, but he does like a bunch of, you know, he'll do like interviews and stuff for before the game or at halftime and stuff. Are you turning this up?
No, I love how we're talking about movies and you moved on to fucking basketball talking.
Because it's like this is in the background.
Of what?
Of our talking.
Oh.
That's the whole point. That's what background music is for. Mm. People can tune us out and listen to the background music if they want, if they love this song as much as you do.
I love this song.
How many times do I have to listen to this song during the movie if I watch it?
Just at one time. It's at the end of the movie. That's it.
Also, you know what happened?
What?
I started to really fucking hate Tom Cruise.
Why? Because he's a Scientologist? We already talked about this before.
Yeah, pretty much. But, you know, I didn't hate him before. I thought he was just a little kooky. Like,
he is kooky.
Well, he's nuts or whatever.
He's fucking nuts.
Yeah.
But I love his movies,
I didn't
man.
Know that Scientology had such a dark, like, background. I thought it was just like, we're doing this for a tax break. But the way that they treat like kids and families, and it's total cult.
We already talked about this. He said going clear. We already talked about
this. Yeah, I know, but that's my point is I think I might be not wanting to see this anymore because Tom Cruise is in it. Like, I loved...
Just put it this way. He wasn't a Scientologist at this point.
Are you? Are we sure?
Yeah. I think Scientology
was
like...
He and his parents were Scientologists. I think his parents were in it, too.
No.
I think so, because he still talks to his mom. If she wasn't a Scientologist, they wouldn't be talking.
Yeah?
Guaranteed.
It's
fucked up.
I don't care what he does in his personal life. I don't give a fuck.
Well, if it's like abusing kids and
he's
people.
He's not abusing kids.
That Scientologist, did you watch the fucking documentary?
You're saying every Scientologist abuses. Now you're making. You're
watch the documentary.
Abuse kids.
Yes, that the organization abuses the kids. They use child labor. They fucking cook them
to
up.
To make tennis shoes for Nike or what?
They also brainwash the kids and stuff. You know, the same way they do the adults. It's bad. Just watch the fucking documentary and you wouldn't be arguing.
Yeah, Leah Remini says Tom Cruise could single-handedly.
Yeah, but he won't.
Single-handedly bring down Scientology.
Well, he'll be in control of it soon.
Well, he's like the second man right now.
Yeah. Who is that guy?
It's the fucking devil, dude.
Really?
Yeah. You've never watched this. Apparently, you never really watched this movie in depth.
It was fucking
That's so
years
fucking badass,
ago.
Man. You're like, oh, it's Chintzy. No, it's fucking badass. It's still badass this today. You know how you watch movies?
The unicorn.
Yeah. You're laughing at a unicorn and you're talking about fucking Neverending Story and there's a flying dog with scales.
It's a dog dragon. It's a dragon. Does a unicorn shove its horn?
Unicorns exist.
Up the devil's ass. Oh no, he stabs the devil with the unicorn horn.
Yep.
What happened to the unicorn? Did he die without his horn?
No, he pulls it out. I love it. Made by Zanny1234X. Really? Yeah, it was Ridley Scott. Ridley Scott did that, dude. I can't believe you're giving a shit.
I'm not
the
giving
premise
a shit.
Of the movie, and you're like,
I'm just saying I'm not watching it a shitload.
I've watched both movies, and you're giving the shit, and you don't even realize
what's
happening.
I haven't watched
the movie
for like 20 years. How am I supposed to remember how good it is?
That's why I'm saying we need to have mandate night.
Is that a mandate?
Mandate.
Like you have to do it because it's a mandate. Do you get it? Do you get that joke? Kevin Kubler is the best announcer in the fucking on the radio, and I think he's better than anyone I've ever heard. And they've been a lot of.
You don't even know how to spell his name.
Oh, well, just because it was a typo doesn't mean I don't know how to spell it.
Here we go, talking about sports talkers.
Oh, never mind. It's fine. I wonder if it is Kubler, K-O-O. They don't spell it for you on the air.
You're a big fan, I can tell.
Well, I'm not fucking such an asshole.
How do you... big fan of Kevin...
That's how you say his name. I said it right.
Fuck, how do you spell that?
I guarantee you this is how you spell it. Nope, not a lot on YouTube about him, so we'll move on. I'm telling you, he's the best, dude. You need to listen to some sports.
I want you guys listening to the Flummery just to know that Adam is a big fan of Kevin.
I'm getting flustered. I wish I had a lottery ticket right now.
Kevin Kubler.
There's lots of people. There's people that I know that listen to this show who know exactly who I'm talking about.
That's good.
And they're going to hate you for the way you're talking about
it. Yeah, because you don't know how to spell his last name.
I do know how to spell his last name. They don't spell, he doesn't, hey, this is Kevin Kubler, K-U-B-L-E-R.
Well, he should.
Why?
Or you should research him a little bit more.
That's not what.
If you're going to try to research him on the show here.
I wasn't researching him. I wanted to talk about how great I thought he was. You got to give somebody props when they're the best at what they do. That's why you're not getting props tonight.
Who's not getting props?
You're not getting any props tonight.
Oh, is that what happens to the devil in the legend? It's such a dumb movie. I don't even recall.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
Stop it.
You bitch. Fuck you.
Stop it.
All right, now you're just being dumb.
Well, I just don't want it to fall out here.
Here's how it works.
Here's how it works. When you listen to the radio and you listen to radio sports, if you're hearing Kevin Kubler, you're hearing the best. That's the deal. I want to make sure I said that tonight.
Yeah.
I kind of wish I was listening to that right now, but I will be when I leave. So you're not interested at all to see who wins the national championships?
No.
It's probably, you know what? I'm surprised you don't appreciate it because it seems like your type of deal where if you, like, they have to win 6 games in a row to win the championship in a tournament. That's a big tournament.
How's Minnesota faring in that?
They lost in the first round.
Yeah.
Yeah.
One of the biggest upsets.
Not really, but.
Who? What's that team? Nashville Dance Team?
Is that who Memphis, Tennessee Southern? I don't know.
Who?
No, I don't know. I can't remember.
No, I mean, who is that? What team is that?
I can't remember.
Who?
What? I can't remember who it is, but that really pissed me off. They should have beat the shit out of that team. And I don't care what people say. Oh, well, you know, they upset Michigan State last year. It's like, yeah, well, Michigan State sucked too then. Yeah. Should have beat
Apparently
the shit.
Apparently Minnesota does this year too.
They did. They should have beat the shit out of them. It was just, but you know what? I wasn't expecting a big thing this year. We got better than we expected out of the Gophers, and they're young. Lots of freshmen on that team.
So, weren't they freshmen last year?
No. So it's starting to look real good.
Yeah.
Next year should be pretty good.
Yeah.
For how much they won this year, and they're going to have all the same guys back.
What's basketball again?
Basketball. It's pronounced basketball.
Backstabbing ball.
Yeah.
The game of backstabbing ball.
What's going on?
Just
trust me.
Kevin Kubler is the best.
Can you spell his last name for the audience?
K-U-B-L-E-R. I bet that's how you spell it.
No.
Yeah.
It's funny how he wasn't even on YouTube.
YouTubes. Well, he does radio. Well, we're on YouTube. You should subscribe.
Yeah, you should subscribe.
You should subscribe right now.
And with that, should I think we're going to call it an evening.
I'm looking up Kevin Kubler right now.
Because we're done with Kevin Kubler. Fuck Kevin Kubler. You can't even fucking bring him up decently on
Is
the podcast.
Is it Kubler? I wonder if it's the G.
It's French for Dutch.
It is.
And with that, we're done.
It is.
Have a good night.
It's Kevin Kugler.
Bye.
I walk 47 miles of barbed wire. I got a cobra snake for a necktie. A brand new house along the roadside. And it's made out of rattlesnake hide. Got a brand new tin that baby put on top. And it's made out of human skull. Come on, take a little walk with me, baby, and tell me who do you love?